JumpCloud Sysprep application is a utility for JumpCloud admins to use to migrate their existing Windows machines to JumpCloud. In situations where the existing local Windows usernames do not match the intended naming convention of the JumpCloud usernames, in order for account takeover to occur, the local usernames must be updated to match the JumpCloud usernames. This is option one of the Sysprep utility, renaming a local user account. Additionally, admins can use the utility to rename the hostnames of their computers and then install or uninstall the JumpCloud agent. Let's look how each feature of the JumpCloud Sysprep utility works, starting with installing the utility. The JumpCloud Sysprep application can be downloaded through the JumpCloud Sysprep module, hosted on the PowerShell gallery. Note that this module is only intended to be installed on Windows machines running PowerShell version 4 or later. In order to install modules from the PowerShell gallery, the execution policy of your PowerShell session must be set to at least remote signed. To see your execution policy, run the command git execution policy. Here, you'll see that I have my execution policy set to remote signed. After confirming that your session allows for the installation of modules, simply run the command install module jumpcloud.sysprep. You'll be prompted to confirm the installation, and at this prompt, hit Y for yes. Note, the JumpCloud PowerShell module is a dependency of the JumpCloud Sysprep module and will also be installed if it's not already present on your system. After the module is installed, there's a single command to run to download the JumpCloud Sysprep application. To see this command, we can see the contents of the module by running the command git command module JumpCloud Sysprep. The git JCSysprep command downloads the JumpCloud Sysprep application to our local machine. After entering the git JCSysprep command, administrators will be prompted for the JumpCloud API key. This key is used to package their system connect key into the application. To find the JumpCloud API key, simply navigate to the JumpCloud admin console, select the drop-down next to the administrator email on the top of the screen, and navigate to API settings. Copy this key out and paste it into the prompt. You'll see that the JCSysprep application will be created in the current working directory of your PowerShell session. In this case, I've navigated to my desktop. Enter Y to confirm the creation of the JumpCloud Sysprep application. To launch the JumpCloud Sysprep application, note you have to run it as administrator. If you run it without administrative permissions, you'll get an error and be asked to relaunch it as administrator. Right-click on the exe and select Run as Administrator to launch it. It's important for administrators using the Sysprep utility to understand that their system connect key is embedded inside the exe. This means that any installs done with the exe will register that system to their organization's JumpCloud tenant. Let's look at the different use cases for using this utility, starting with renaming a local user account. You'll see under the system info, it shows the system name, the logged in user, and the status of this JumpCloud agent. In this case, I'm logged in as user admin. By selecting one at the menu prompt, I enter the rename user screen. I cannot rename the signed in user, who in this case is admin. You'll see there's two users, KSense and LannyLearn on this machine. On Windows machines, you can include spaces in the username. This is not a character that can be used in a JumpCloud username, so this is a good example of a use for this utility where I'd want to rename LannyLearn to maybe something that matches his JumpCloud username, Lanny.learn. To rename Lanny, I select option 2 at this screen. Let's rename him to the username of his JumpCloud username, which is LannyLearn. To confirm the username change, I hit Y at the prompt. If I wish to cancel, I can hit Q. Lanny's account has now been updated. We've updated his username, his home folder, the registry path that points to this home folder, and also his display name. We can see this a number of ways. Navigating to this PC, users, seeing his home folder, and also if we go to the change user screen, we'll see this is updated to Lanny.learn. The utility has only updated Lanny's username. It has not affected any of his files or folders, and his password remains his same password. Renaming a computer is easy with the utility. To rename a computer, I select option 2, enter a new computer name, and then hit Y to confirm. In this case, I'm going to hit Q to cancel because I don't really feel like restarting right now. Now that we've got Lanny's name updated, let's go ahead and install the JumpCloud agent. To install the JumpCloud agent using the utility, I simply enter option 3 at the prompt. After a few moments, the agent will be installed and the system will now be registered with by JumpCloud organization. My system has showed up in my admin console, and now I can bind my user with my matching username to the system. Let's find Lanny. This demonstrates how to onboard an existing Windows workstation to JumpCloud when there may be a username mismatch. Admins can distribute the JumpCloud Sysprep application that they create to their machines through a flash drive, by sending it as a zip file, or perhaps hosting on a network share. Find the full documentation and use case for using the JumpCloud Sysprep utility inside the JumpCloud knowledge base. This article is also linked in this video's description.